Plutarco Calles and the Construction of the Post-Revolutionary State. In 1924, Plutarco Elias Calles became the new official president of the Mexican Republic. His rise to political success was directly influenced by his ties to President Álvaro Obregón, who he held the position of Interior Minister under. Álvaro Obregón, the president from 1920 to 1924, had been the commander of the revolutionary forces in North Mexico against the Huerta regime. He assumed full command of the rebellion in 1920 when he ousted Venustiano Carranza, who had been the leader of the revolution to that point. Following that, Obregón was elected president and saw in Calles a capable successor. Obregón set the standard for how Calles would act. Alvaro's presidency was characterized by social reforms. This included educational distribution, with the creation of around 1,000 schools in rural Mexico and 2,000 libraries, a renewed emphasis on the arts and cultural expression, and the shared historical memory of the revolution. Obregón also played an important role in establishing a new labor bureau and had a more effective form of land reform than his predecessors adopted. These achievements were indicators for the direction of Calles' presidency when he took office. Starting in 1924, Mexico entered the Maximato era, a time of transition and change for the people of Mexico. The father of this movement, Plutarco Elias Calles, was known as El Jefe Máximo, hence the name Maximato era. In 1928, Obregón was assassinated, and in an effort to end the re-election cycle Mexico had struggled with for most of its history, Calles opted not to run for presidency. He instead made Emilio Portes Gil the interim president, but in truth Calles was the one behind the wheel. He would control Mexican politics through three separate presidencies, and entered Mexico into a period of reform. Calles controlled the Mexican political scene through his party, the National Revolutionary Party. Previously, Mexican political parties had only existed for the election cycle, but Calles established the NRP as a permanent institution. Through this party, he was able to indirectly be the leader of Mexico from 1924 until 1938. In 1929, a presidential election was held. Calles chose Pascual Ortiz Rubio as his figurehead, but Rubio was too independent from Calles' rule for his liking, so he was quickly replaced by Alvarado Rodriguez. Calles' predecessor, Obregón, had not stringently enforced the Constitution of 1917. The Constitution had articles that worked to separate the church from the state, reduce their role in education, and take away much of the historical power of the church. Calles took a different approach. He embraced these reforms wholeheartedly. He worked to reinforce Article 130 of the 1917 Mexican Constitution through his Calles laws. These reforms took away many of the special privileges the Catholic Church had previously enjoyed. Priests were no longer allowed to serve in public office, inherit property, except from blood relatives, or canvass for political parties. Harsh policies such as fines for wearing clerical garb in public was punishable by fine. Priests who spoke out against the government faced a prison sentence of up to 5 years. The church disapproved of his anti-clerical actions and helped support armed rebellions of unhappy Catholics across Mexico, claiming religious persecution. Catholics across the country took arms and became involved in a violent clash between the government forces. Over the course of the war, over 40 priests were killed. At the start of the war, Mexico had over 4,500 priests. By its end, only 334 priests were licensed by the state. The government executed over 50 Cristero leaders and almost 5,000 other Cristeros. At the end of the Cristero War, it is estimated that almost 5% of Mexico's population emigrated from Mexico. The Cristero War came to a close after peace talks moderated by American Ambassador Dwight Morrow. Calles' law was eventually repealed by Calles' successor, Lázaro Cárdenas. Under Cárdenas, relations between the Catholic Church and the federal government greatly improved, but many states still refused to repeal all or certain aspects of Calles' law. Plutarco's reforms were highly focused on the social emancipation of campesinos, or peasant farmers. Plutarco Calles' chosen policy was to take land into the government, process it, and then redistribute it. This meant the breaking up of haciendas and church lands, repossessing them, and then giving it back to the people. This policy, with the government in the middle acting as the principal business, took away power from the churches and the wealthy landowners, causing mass frustration and disapproval from powerful individuals. For these reasons, it was not highly effective, and though some land was retained, the most that was done was occasional land or territorial reform, and support for communal lands that campesinos could work off of. The legacy of Álvaro Obregón was seen in the advancements in education that Plutarco continued to pursue throughout his presidency. Plutarco envisioned education as a platform for transforming post-revolutionary Mexico. José Vasconcelos and Moises Sanz were the two leading secretaries for the Department of Public Education. Both promoted the education of the masses and the consolidation of educational systems. Sanz had particular importance for expanding public education to secondary school, allowing many campesinos the ability to further their education and make more of themselves. The vision of education during this time revolved around uniting the state, both rural and urban, in the ability to learn and establishing the foundations for rural aggrandizement. Where Plutarco faltered in land reforms, his educational department made up for it with highly successful policies with proven results. By the 1930s, the liberalism of the Maximato era was coming to a close. The socialist policies of Calles' regime were slowly eliminated. Land redistribution and organized labor movements were suppressed and ended in some cases. Calles argued that the Mexican agrarian advancement superseded the need for social change. His government allowed fascist groups to terrorize Mexico's Jewish population, and the NRP actively suppressed Mexico's Communist Party. After protests from the left wing of the NRP, Calles sought to bring liberal values back into his political machine. As a way to prevent a party split within the NRP, Calles nominated Lázaro Cárdenas for the 1934 presidential election. Cárdenas had gained acclaim in his home state of Michoacán for supporting public education and having a good relationship with organized labor and campesinos. He was widely recognized as populist, but Calles expected him to be a good puppet, just as his predecessors. Despite the popularity of Calles' reforms among many, the reign of Calles over Mexico and the Maximato era came to a close in 1938. During the 1934 election cycle, Manuel Pérez Trevino and Lázaro Cárdenas had become favorites to run on the NRP ticket. Calles worked to have Trevino win the nomination, hoping that he was the most likely candidate to act as his puppet. However, pressure from party officials led to the eventual nomination of Cárdenas as the NRP candidate. It was expected that the two would cooperate as previous leaders had, but their relationship soon fell apart. Calles was frustrated by Cárdenas' support for labor unions and tolerance for strikes. Cárdenas was appalled by a Calles' use of force and violent suppression of resistance. Cárdenas also struggled with Calles' effort to integrate fascist principles into the government. Slowly, Cárdenas removed Calles' followers from positions of power. Eventually, Calles himself was taken out of power and deported to the U.S. While in the United States, Calles befriended many fascists, but denounced their anti-Mexican and Semitic positions. In 1941, Manuel Avila Camacho, Cárdenas' successor, allowed Calles to re-enter the country under the reconciliation policy. Calles spent the remainder of his years living quietly in Mexico City with a more moderate political position. Calles ushered in a new era for Mexico. After the Revolutionary War, his creation of the NRP allowed for a more organized Mexican political system. The NRP can also be attributed to a long, undemocratic period in Mexican history. His reforms reinforced the Constitution of 1917 and led to advancements in multiple disciplines. However, his persecution of Catholics and Jews and his increasingly authoritarian rule over the Mexican state served to diminish his heroic qualities. His status of champion of the people continues to stand, as the legacy of his educational and social reforms, which were grounded in liberalism, continued to shape the way Mexico developed after Calles had lost his power.